Well, I just came inside from harvesting all this basil. Oh, it smells so good. I can't believe how much I got just from pruning back my plants. So if you haven't watched that video, I'll put a link to it at the end. But we're not talking about basil today. I'll do something with this later. What I want to talk today about is about peppers. I picked all these peppers yesterday. Got a really great, nice start to my harvest with the peppers. And I can't use all these within the next couple days, but I want to keep them really nice and fresh. So what I'm going to do today is I'm going to freeze them so that we can use them in individual servings if we want to, or we can save up a whole bunch so that I can make pepper jelly in maybe a month or so. So let me just show you what I like to do. This is so easy and so quick. And I really love to have these in my freezer for all kinds of different things. But I'm going to actually use my kitchen shears, or these are actually not even kitchen shears, they're just regular old scissors that I just use in the kitchen, by the way. And I'm going to use these to cut my peppers into strips, which is so much easier than using a knife and so much less time consuming than chopping them all into tiny little pieces. So it's so simple. All I do is I just cut off the end. And these peppers really don't have a lot of seeds. And then what I'm going to do is just cut them down the middle and I'm going to freeze them in strips. That way I can use them for different things. I can use them for fajitas, which we really like to do, or I can chop them after they're frozen into smaller pieces to put into like egg dishes, which we like to have a lot, or any other dishes that, you know, you need them into smaller pieces. They're actually a whole lot easier to cut when they're frozen. So that's all I do, just snip off the ends, cut down the middle. So I have nice strips for fajitas or for grilling. And this is a nice mixture of a few hot peppers in here mixed with sweet peppers, which would make a great combination in fajitas. So I'm gonna go ahead and get these cut up and I'll come back and show you what I do with them next. I've got my peppers cut up and spread out on my cookie sheet here. And what I'm gonna do now is just stick these in the freezer for a couple of hours. And the reason why I put them on a cookie sheet is because that way they will freeze in individual pieces rather than in one big clump like they might if you put them in a freezer bag. So let me stick these in the freezer for a couple hours and I'll come back and show you what the next step is. Well, my peppers have been in the freezer for just a couple hours, just enough to get them hard so that we can put them in the freezer bag. They're not totally frozen solid. That's okay. I've got my freezer bag here labeled and I've got the date on it. Last step, very simple. Put them in the freezer bag, pop them in the freezer, and they'll be ready to pull out for individual servings, for grilling, for chopping up and making pepper jelly out of it a little later in the season when I have a whole lot more. And that's about all there is to it. Now I do try and get a lot of the air out before I throw them in the freezer. And you can even use a little straw trick where you put a straw in here and suck all the air out if you want to get it really nice and airtight. Okay, so that's about it. Let me know how you like to use peppers, how you like to preserve or freeze peppers. I know there's lots of different ways to do it. This is just one little thing I like to do to make my life a little simpler. So thanks a lot for watching and have a great day.